Second question, A part. What will be the output? For variable in range 1, 15, 3, print where? So student, first of all, let's see the difference between range and arrange. Arrange function creates an array, but range function creates a list. So here, a list will be created, and this variable takes each time one element of the list. So after taking the element in the variable, it will print that variable. So starting from first, then after adding 3, it will get 4, then 7, then 10, and then 13. So what should be the answer? Answer will be written in this form. Next question. Write code to create 1D array of size 10 with all elements as 0, but 7th element should be 12. So students, we have many functions to create array, but the most convenient here we can use is zeros function in this way. First, we will write numpy.zeros with argument 10. It will create an array with all value 0 and size 10, means 10 elements. After that, we have to change the 7th element as 12. So we will write array of 6 equal to 12. How it will change the 7th element? Because index starts always with 0. Next question. Write the statement to create a 2D array named myArray having integer values from 0 to 8 of shape 3, 3 using arrange function and using linear space function. Students, here we can use arrange function in three possible ways. How? Let's see. First of all, we can write arrange 0, 9, 1, means starting from 0, it have to go till 9, but 9th element will not be included and in steps of 1. So it will create the values from 0 to 8. After creating the array, we will reshape it into 3 rows and 3 columns using the reshape function. Next possible option with arrange is we can also write 0, 9, because if we will not give the step value, default step value is always 1. One another possible option we can use is arrange of 9, because if we use arrange function with only one argument, it will always create an array starting from 0 up to given number minus 1. So these are three possible options with arrange. Now let's see the linear space function, how it will work. It will work in this way, means it will take three arguments 0, 8, 9, means you have to take 9 values between 0 to 8 which are linearly spaced. After creating the array, again we will reshape it using the reshape function. Next question, question second, D part. How are the following functions different? X limit and X ticks. Students, X limits function always is used to set the minimum and maximum limits for X axis, but X ticks functions is used to give the tick marks on the X axis. So you can write, it sets the minimum and maximum limits, but X ticks sets the specified position on X axis. Next, what will be the value of A, B, C, D if? These are the four statements which are creating four different arrays using different functions and with different arguments. So in the first function, we have used linear space function with three arguments 11, 25, 5. First of all, let's see how this function works. These are the three arguments A, B and C. And how it will calculate the linear difference B minus A upon C minus 1. So 25 minus 11 upon C minus 1, that is 5 minus 1, it will come out to be 3.5. So it will create the array. First element will be 11. After adding 3.5, it will give 14.5. Next element will be 18. Next element 21.5 and next element will be 25. Next, identity function. It is the same as I function and it will give an array with given dimension as unit matrix and it will give the result as. Third function is arrange function with arguments 1, 5, 2, means starting from first it have to go up to 5 in steps of 2. Because last index is not included, it will give only result 1, 3. Next element arrange 5, it will create the array starting from 0 to n minus 1 in steps of 1. So it will be the answer. Next question, write code to calculate variance and median of all the elements of following given array. Now for variance function we will use var function, and for finding out the median we will use the median function of numpy module. So first we will import the numpy module, and then we will write numpy dot var variance function, and in the arguments we will give the array name. Next, numpy dot median array 1. Next question, write code to calculate average of ip column of following given data frame df, also write the output. Students, there are four possible options to find the average of ip column. How? Let's see. There are four options. First, you can find the mean using df.mean. After finding the mean or average, if you want to display only the result of ip column, you can write in this way. You can also write ip, that is column name, in this way. Python also allows it. Next option is, before finding the average function, you can give the name of the column in this way. Also, you can write in this way. Here, by mistake, I have omitted. It should be written as in this way. Next, what will be the output? It is 14.33. Next question, second H part, explain pivoting with example. This is the most confusing question for students, but it's very easy. Let's see. It is a summarization technique which rearranges data from rows and columns in a report form so that data can be viewed from different perspective. Now see how different perspective. Suppose I have a data frame. There are three tutors, Mr. Vikram, Ms. Sheetal and Mr. Amit, who is taking the classes +2 and +1, and their number of periods are given in this form. If there are only two classes or three tutors, then it is very easy to check which tutor is taking which classes and how many number of periods. But if number of tutors are more and number of classes are more, it is very difficult to find immediately how many teachers are taking how many classes and how many number of periods. So if we want the result in this form, we can write the pivot function in this way. How it will work? If we will write index equal to classes, means it will make this as index. If we will write column equal to tutor, means name of the tutors will become as the columns. And values equal to periods means values, these values will become the values of this perspective. Here you can see, if Mr. Amit is not taking +1 class, then NAN will be inserted in this column. Next question, explain various arguments of plot function. Plot function is used to draw line chart, and the various elements are this one. Here data 1 is the first data series which will be plotted on x-axis. Data 2 is the second data series which will be plotted on y-axis. Color is used to change the color of line. Line style is used to change the pattern of line. Line width is used to change the width of the line. How thick will be the line. Marker is used to change the shape of the marker. Marker size is used to change the size of the marker, and marker edge color is used to change the color of the marker. So you have to explain this properly in this way.